Hey, today we're gonna go over 9 hidden benefits of raw land investing and why you need vacant land as an investment. Hey guys, this is Paul Jang and we're just gonna get straight to it. So the first thing you have to know about buying land is that if you have some kind of retirement plans and you have like some kind of IRA, you can stick land in a self-directed IRA, right? So you're gonna need a custodian to set this up for you, but you type it in, self-directed IRA. You can put your mutual funds, your index funds, but real estate is something that you could grow and get tax benefits, so at the end you don't have to pay taxes on it. You could grow tax deferred. So some of the things you're gonna have to do if you use this is that you are gonna want to look at land in potentially growing areas. When you set it up in a self-directed IRA account, you're gonna be able to move things over, but you can hold a real property asset like land in that account and just let it appreciate over time. So if you know like you bought a piece of land kind of in the outskirts of a city, and that city is growing, you see demographics moving into that city, you know, over time, developers are gonna want to use that land. And if your retirement is, you know, in the next 10, 20, 30, 40 years, it could be a significant amount of money that we're talking about. And when you make your sales, you can do it all within your self-directed IRA. And the main benefit of this is that when you sell this piece of land, you won't get taxed on it. So just check with your custodian of the self-directed IRA to, you know, for information on how to, you know, set this up exactly. But that's a cool idea if you thought about buying assets into your retirement fund that are a little bit different from everyone else. The next thing that's really cool with raw land investing is that you could put livestock on it. And if you have livestock, it'll basically lower your property taxes. So if you had thoughts of buying land and eventually building on it, you know, at one point, check with your state and see that, you know, if you could get livestock to lower your tax bill. So you will be able to find that most states will have this benefit. So check on that. That is a hidden benefit that most people don't know about. And this amount can be pretty significant. You know, if we're talking about large acreage, the values are a little bit higher and you might want that tax break. Just so you know, a lot of developers that like buy commercial, that develop commercial properties, what they'll do is they'll put cattle or something on the land as they're waiting for their other projects to finish up so that they can lower their property tax amount. Just something that you know, it's kind of cool, a hidden benefit. In terms of real estate investing, which I do, it is one of the least competitive real estate investment strategies, right? So that's hidden benefit number 3, right? It's just, there's nothing kind of like it, right? Whenever you hear about real estate investing, generally you kind of think like, oh, you know, rehabbing homes, or you know, if you look into that a little bit more closely, you'll find out about wholesaling houses. Basically, you find these really good deals and flip it over to rehabbers. You know, there's a lot of that, right? But you're not really competing with any of that because land is pretty niche in the real estate investing community. You'll have like real estate investors basically saying, you know, don't invest in land at all because they don't really understand how you could profit out of it. But the thing is, because there's so little competition, you're able to buy these parcels of lot for super cheap and then flip it for cash or terms. It's something that like a lot of real estate investors don't realize the potential with. A hidden benefit within this niche is because like we're talking usually smaller amounts of money, realtors aren't really targeting parcels of land, right? So basically what's going on is, whereas houses, you're getting real estate investors interested in buying up homes, as well as realtors, you know, trying to get that listing, right, so that they can make a commission off of it. You know, there's really no one targeting landowners. And what that really means for you is that they are super motivated to selling their land, right? So You know, if you're not familiar with real estate investing, it is a hidden benefit that you might not have considered before, but you're able to buy these parcels of land super cheap and sell it for a quick buck. Hidden benefit number four is that property taxes are lower with vacant land. So if you aren't familiar with it, whenever you have a house, there's two taxes you pay for property taxes. One is the land itself, and then you also pay for the physical dwelling, right? The house itself. And it'll depreciate over time, so you get tax benefits if you own a house. But with land, because you don't have this dwelling, what ends up happening is that your tax bill is ultimately lower than if you had a physical property on top of it. So generally with vacant land, especially the smaller lots, you know, not like 100, 200 acres, but you know, closer to 10 acres and less, you'll find that in a lot of like rural vacant land, it's 30 bucks a year, 50 bucks a year. The property taxes are pretty minimal. So we're talking about like $3-5 in a month. It can go up, it can go down, it just kind of depends on the values, what price point you're kind of targeting. But I kind of found like, you know, if you're talking about like 20-30,000, it's much less than it would be if you're talking about like some kind of house. Another benefit with raw land investing is if you had any thoughts about hunting, farming, driving, you know, on, you know, a piece of land with an ATV, or if you want to stow away an RV on a piece of lot, or you want to, you know, ultimately sell the land for profit, like you can mix pleasure and business with land investing. Here's what I mean, right? Because tip number three, right, we said that it's so uncompetitive. What ends up happening is you're able to find these super deals with land, and it's much easier than, you know, other, you know, real estate investment strategies, right? So what you're able to do is you're able to mix pleasure and business. And what I mean by that is, let's say there's a piece of land, 10 acres, and it's $30,000, right, in value. In reality, you could get something similar to that at $10,000-$15,000, right? So, you know, 50%, you know, undervalue of what it should be. And what you're able to do is, let's just go with the 50%. If the property's worth 30 and you bought it for 15, you could go ahead and sell it for cash or for terms, which, you know, that's basically my business model. But let's say it's like land that could lead into farming. What you could do is you could go ahead and farm on that land, you know, build your garden and whatever else, right? And sure, you could sell the crops and make a profit there or whatnot. But because you have your profit margin right there, your equity, you know, you bought something that's worth 30 and you bought it for 15, what ends up happening is when it's time to sell, you can sell it for, you know, 25,000-27,000, assuming that the land didn't appreciate over time. Land generally holds its value very well, and what will happen is you'll profit out of that, right? And so you're able to do this like cool benefit with like raw land investing is, you know, just kind of mix pleasure and business. You want to buy some hunting land because you like hunting, you buy something for 15,000 that's worth 30. You go hunt on the land, and then later down the road you sell it, right, for a profit when you get tired of doing whatever it is, or you just keep it, right? So these are some of the hidden benefits that you can get, right? If it's something that you want to keep for the long term, stick it in your self-directed IRA, let it appreciate, you know, tax-free, and then, you know, you have your pleasure business parcels of property or whatever else, right? And if you want to go ahead and be a real estate developer, stick your livestock on it and save yourself some taxes. All these cool little hidden benefits. All right, so number six, something that most people don't know, and I don't know why they haven't thought about it, is you can build up passive income with land investing. Here's what I mean. The easiest way to do it is to buy a piece of land and sell it on terms. So let's do that same example of, you know, the $30,000 lot, right? You bought it for 15, right? You get a pretty good down payment on it, and then you sell it, you know, for terms, you know, for, you know, $300-$400 per month. So you get most of your money back in the down payment, if not all, and then the rest is just kind of gravy plus, you know, a nice interest for your trouble, right? That's one of the easiest way to get into terms and building up a passive income portfolio with land investing. It's familiar to real estate investors that do creative financing for houses. It's called owner financing. And, you know, basically it happens a lot of time. That's what you hire a real estate lawyer for, to set up your contracts and set up the deal for you if you don't know how to do it, right? Another thing that's pretty popular, and some people have kind of niched into that, like within land, is to get into mineral oil and oil rights. If you're not in a big oil state like Texas, or, you know, somewhere kind of in the south where there's a lot of oil, basically the way it works is if you have minerals or some kind of oil on the property, basically you can lease that over to a company that's, you know, in that business, in the oil business or some kind of mineral business, and they'll extract the minerals or oil from your land and give you a profit. It's also popular if you got like a lot of wood in your piece of land, right? So, you know, a timber company can lease a property off of you, you know, cut that wood, and, you know, ship it in and make their products and furniture and paper and whatever else they want to do with it. And for that privilege of you giving them that leasing, you know, option, basically what will happen is they will give you a monthly stipend, or we call it income, passive income, to you every month. And sure, when you are done, you know, when they're done with the oil or the minerals or whatever, go ahead and sell it for terms, and you'll get an extra nice set of monthly income coming after that lease has been completed. Okay, so another thing that's really popular that you might not have considered with passive income is, think about those billboards, right? Each of those billboards are owned by a company, and they usually own the land right associated with it. So if you have a nice highway, a property right next to a highway, and you are focusing on picking up property that's, you know, next to that, right? Go ahead and build yourself a billboard, check with zoning rights if that's okay, or hire a billboard company to create it and worry about the zoning, you know, on their side, and go ahead and get some passive income. So the mineral and oil rights and billboards obviously require more due diligence. I say go ahead and sell for owner financing and get your terms and build up passive income. But, you know, if you want to go more niche and, you know, do more leasing stuff, like, go ahead and do that as well. Here's the thing, when you sell smaller lots, right, you'll be able to generate more money, right? It's just kind of reality, because you do more deals and just keep it moving. Just food for thought. I highly recommend you check out owner financing terms. There's peace of mind whenever we are talking about raw land investing, and that is tip number 8, peace of mind. With the situation in our country, our political climate and pandemics and this and that, right? You just don't know what might happen to you, right? And if there is a case where you need to get out, you know, you own a piece of land in such and such county, in such and such place, and you could stow away if needed, right? So it's a place to go if something happens. Peace of mind for your family and friends. Here's the thing with number 9, right? They aren't making any more land. There's more land than there are houses, but increasingly as populations increase and people move over from coastal areas into you know, the more rural areas, there will be less and less land, and it will become more and more valuable. And so number 9, they aren't making more land, so, you know, go ahead and get going with it. You know, it's supply and demand, and they aren't making more land. So that's it for your 9 hidden benefits with raw land investing. Some things you might not have considered, you know, if you're totally new with the raw land investing world, and then some hidden benefits that might help you out if you wanted to readjust your investment strategy. All right, this is Paul Jang. Take care. Make sure to subscribe and like this video. This YouTube channel is about building wealth for yourself and getting financial freedom. Put in the comments anything you might want to watch, and I'll try supplying that for y'all. Take care. Have a good one.